The first card that we have is the Ace of Swords. The focus or challenge for the month of July is, you know, either focusing on a victory, kind of, and it can be kind of a mental victory. Maybe you've had to kind of stay one step ahead of someone, kind of figure out what their next move is going to be. And that's what I'm getting, like outmaneuver them in some way. And you've either finally done that, or in July you will be feeling like you've done that. Or there's a new idea, a new way forward for solving a problem, or for moving forward in some way. For some of you, this could have something to do with money or a loss of some sort. Does not have to be money, but normally with Fehu, it is a material loss of some sort. So you may be trying to have a new way forward for saving money, for recouping some money. Maybe you had a big payout recently and you're kind of trying to figure out, okay, maybe with a partner, for those of you that are married or living with someone, how do we recoup that? Or how can we, maybe you had an emergency come up in June and you had to get something fixed, or something ended up costing more than you were thinking it was going to. And now you're trying to kind of talk and figure out, okay, how can we bring in more money or replace that money that we had to spend? And, you know, so that could be a topic of conversation. Some of you may be in July trying to, this is going to be specific for some of you. It's like you signed up for a dating service. It's like you were trying to meet a match or trying to even find a job, but it's almost, I don't know if they have like matchmakers for jobs. I feel like they do, but this is like, or maybe it's a headhunter, someone that you were paying to, you know, find you a partner or find you the right job, match you up with the right person or the right job. And it's like, you feel like you've given it enough money, and it was, you know, for some of you, it may have cost quite a bit and they didn't deliver on what they were supposed to do. And now you're trying to get out of that in July. You're putting an end to it. You know, it seems like they talked a good game, but they didn't deliver. And so you're trying to get out of that. Some of you may have been putting this off. Oh God, I don't want to deal with this, but you know, and some of you may be trying to get your money back, you know, so you may be trying to do that. Trying to at least recoup some of the money that you spent on that. It's like, hey, you didn't find me my match, or you didn't find me a job, so I'm just going to go off on my own. I'm going to go do this on my own. But yes, yeah, some of you may be getting a gift of money. Because Gifu is coming up here. So, I mean, someone may be, yeah, gifting you money that just kind of comes at just the right time. So, you know, or it could be a gift of a loan, or someone helping you out of a jam. Because again, we were talking about a new solution to a problem. So, for some of you, this may be a gift from your partner's family, or from someone who is connected to your partner instead of you. Some of you, there may be a new message or a new idea regarding a financial situation, or a new opportunity. Some of you have a new business idea, or a new idea that you want to try, that you want to work on, but it's going to take, you know, another person. Some of you are trying, you know, you're talking to someone about investing, you're talking to someone about partnering up with you and starting your own thing. Rather than working for someone else. July, if you're staying at your job, does not seem to be the time to ask for a raise or ask for, you know, a promotion or anything, because it seems like it would be denied. I feel like those of you that are dissatisfied with your job, or especially with your pay, you've got some sort of new idea of how to handle it. And I feel like this all comes from, you know, from you, instead of someone sending you an idea or talking to you about it. You kind of come up with this on your own, or you're starting to kind of think of it in new ways, or look at it from different angles. So because I'm a separation from a situation does come up here. So and you also have the Eight of Swords here in reverse. So this is a card that talks about freeing yourself from some sort of self-imposed prison. So I mean, this can be staying at a job that you could have left ages ago, but you just didn't maybe believe in yourself enough, or didn't maybe the situation wasn't bad enough yet. But I feel like many of you have a financial goal, or you have something you want to do that's going to require you bring in more money. For some of you, maybe you are getting married. There's, again, Gifu's on the table. A partnership is coming up here. So for some of you, you may need money because you're planning a wedding. You are wanting to buy a home with your partner. There's something that you want to do, and you're trying to, you know, it's like solving a puzzle. You're trying to figure out a new way to do it. But yeah, there is something to do with it, with a divorce, a separation, you leaving a person or a situation behind. And it's like weird is here. So it's like once you walk through that door, you're free. And so for some of you, this may have already happened. Those of you that it hasn't, you know, it's coming in July. You're being guided to do whatever this was, because we have Aeol here, which is the rune of spiritual guidance, of your spirit guides kind of taking your hand and leading you, pulling you. Capricorn, sometimes they have to drag you, but they will, because you don't like change, you don't like risk, you like things to stay the same. Unfortunately, I just told Taurus this as well, because they have kind of that same earth sign. You're so grounded that sometimes you get stuck in the mud. You know, and you like everything to be predictable, but the one predictable thing about life is it is unpredictable. And you know, if you want to change something drastically, like your money, your paycheck, sometimes you have to take drastic steps. But yeah, there was a new way forward regarding money loss, or something that was costing you, a place that was like a dead end, or a situation that was a dead end, as now you're released from bondage. And your spirit guides are leading you every step of the way, and will continue to do so in July. And the help that's going to be available to you here, we have Two of Rods in reverse and Wunyo here as well. So yeah, regarding a shift or a change, I feel like the wrong opportunities or offers that you should not accept are going to, you're going to notice them right away. So if you're looking for a new job, and you're just like, oh, this sounds exactly like the place I'm trying to get out of, or these responsibilities seem a lot for the pay, or this pay is less than what I was making, it's like you'll know immediately. No, you know, it's like you'll be marking those out. No. You're going to leave when it's the right time, and you're going to know when it's the right opportunity to accept. So, but yeah, I feel like for most of you, anyone who's like, oh, I can match you up, or anybody who's trying to kind of get money out of you, you shouldn't have to spend money to find a new job. There's so many avenues online these days. Now, if you're in a very specialized field, that could be different for you. But in general, which this reading is, for the majority, vast majority of people, with the internet, I mean, you know, you don't really need to pay someone or hire someone to find you a job. Because, you know, you can find them on your own if you're just willing to kind of get on the internet and do the research. But yeah, I think you're going to know right away. No, this sounds like just the wrong thing. Some of you may, like if you're looking in July to find the right job, try not to get down on yourself if you're not finding opportunities, because I feel some of you may see a sign while you're out and about, and that's the right one. Because, you know, when you're moving in transit, driving, just doing your day-to-day routine, it seems like for many of you, that's when the help comes in. That's when the right opportunity presents itself. Now, the Two of Rods can also talk about partnerships, but it's normally, you know, it can be a relationship, but it's normally not a romantic one. So, I mean, if there has been a split or a separation, which we kind of talked about between you and someone you care about, you know, it seems like their leaving is a blessing for you. It's coming up as a help to you. And, you know, there may be some sadness or loss tied up in this, but you know, again, it's tied to the spirit guide, you know, your spirit guide. You know it's the right situation, or you know a move was the right thing to do for those of you that are moving in July. But so yeah, anything that's coming up that's a disappointment around that, or anything that you kind of thought was gonna, you were gonna be able to do maybe in a new location, in a new home, if it doesn't quite turn out to meet your, to be quite what you thought, that's okay. I mean, you're still making the right decision with any shift or change or move. Now, what must be accepted about July? And this is normally external things, others, because we don't have any control over this position. You've got the Four of Pentacles. So yeah, this talks about stability, improving your money. You are going to be taking steps in July to do that. You are going to notice a shift in your money. Things are going to seem more stable. You're going to feel a lot more communicative. You're going to feel a lot more, you're going to feel very supported, by your family, friends, those who care about you. And, there may be a surprising development regarding a new beginning with someone that you care about. Those of you that are studying or who are in school, you could have found maybe your studies were disrupted lately, or, you know, there may have been, like maybe you haven't been able to devote as much time to that because you've had so much stuff going on with work or your home life, but, now you're able to focus again. And, for some of you, there's a completion here as well. So you may be completing a certification, completing a degree, completing a course of study. And some of you may be starting to looking to study something new. For many of you, it may be online because the rune of online communication, online studies is here. Others of you, you're just getting really good advice, I feel, from these people who support you. And it may be about money. It may be about stability, your home, your family, your health even. But yeah, any disruption will be stabilized, or any previous, anything that kind of comes out of the blue, seems good in July. So, whereas June may have been a different story. There is someone going through a difficult lesson, but I don't feel like Capricorn, for many of you, it's you. I do have the King of Pentacles in reverse. Normally, if this is a person, this is an earth sign energy like you. So it could be another Capricorn, a Taurus, or a Virgo, or someone with those traits. But this is someone who could be male or female in these general readings, who is jealous and possessive and greedy. Sometimes this person is either not very good with money, or they may steal money. They may, you know, this could be somebody who has made their living off of others. In some way, they don't really do for themselves. And the upright, this is a self-made man who works very hard for everything that he has and takes pride in his work, you know. But in the reverse, this is someone who expects everyone else to kind of take care of them, particularly financially and all their needs. And then if those people won't, they will take, find a way to take from them, either by out and out stealing, or, you know, something of that nature. And this could be someone kind of move, you know, trying to take your, someone you're interested in. Those of you that, if you're trying to partner up, with someone, that can be another way this can work. There may be someone kind of moving in on you, on your person. It could be another earth sign. And, but they're not interested in them for the right reasons, or you're kind of seeing through them. For others of you, this could be someone who's in charge at work, who's just not a very good boss. They're not a good leader. Maybe this is part of the reason why you're like, you know what, I got to get out of here. I'm not getting paid enough for this stuff. And, Capricorn, I think that's come up for you a number of times. You tend to stay in situations when they're past their sell by date. And I think for many of you, your job or even your career path, some of you may be looking into, okay, I am going to look for a new gig, but I'm also going to go back to school and find something that will be, you know, offer me even more stability, or offer me something like a plan B, you know, in case this goes, you know, up in smoke. or in case this career path doesn't pan out, I would feel more comfortable with a backup plan or something that I enjoy more, something that I feel drawn to and I want to learn about. So, if you are going back to school or looking into it for the fall, even Capricorn, I do feel something. Maybe it may be finance. You may be like, I should be a financial advisor, or I should go to school and become a CPA or become a banker or something. You know, anytime you guys work with money, I mean, you're usually very good at it. Just don't be this guy who's, you know, this is the, you know, like those people who are, like The Big Short, the movie. Yeah, you know, they're taking from people, profiting off of other people's suffering, that sort of thing. You don't want to be that guy. But no, for many of you, I see July as a door you're walking through, and it's fresh and new. And especially in regards to money, recouping, you know, a big expenditure, getting stability back or making plans to do that. To take steps to do that for the rest of the year. So